Hey guys, Curtis Killen, Vice President at KBD Insurance. I hope everyone's doing well today. Today I'm going to talk about a question that I get asked quite frequently. Do startups need business insurance? The answer is yes, and I'm going to tell you why. So at the beginning of a startup, cash flow is tight. I think everyone knows this. They're spending money on a lot of other things, and insurance isn't always at the top of the list. There are many advantages to purchasing a business insurance policy. One of them being the fact that you're going to give trust to your customers. That's a big thing. Another reason why that it's important to have an insurance policy is that it can, in severe cases, protect you against bankruptcy. Now, I know this sounds a little bit doom and gloom, but in reality, if ever you run into a problem with one of your clients, let's say it's a B2B case, run into a problem with one of your clients, they're much bigger than you, they have more cash than you, they have better lawyers than you do. A startup, you probably don't even have a lawyer yet. And if they want to, they can basically bankrupt you in lawyer's fees, okay? Three things that you should have on your insurance policy, and at the same time, you're not gonna have to break the bank to get these three protections. Number one, liability coverage. In short, this protects you if ever in the case that you were to be sued by a third party. There are many reasons as to why you can get sued for a third party. If it has to do with something with your business services, you would most likely be covered. Again, I can dive into this in more detail, but it's gonna be a lot longer than a 2-minute video. Number two, your contents. So for example, you just purchased $50,000 worth of computers, chairs, desks, a whole bunch of other stuff. There's a fire at your office, water damage at your office. Someone breaks in, you don't have the alarm system installed yet. Someone breaks in, they steal 10 laptops. That's another big thing as well. You can get coverage for this, and it's really not that expensive either. Number three, business interruption. What is business interruption? A lot of people ask me this as well. So let's say, for example, you have a fire at your office. You work, or let's say you're a small startup retail store. If you have a fire, well, you're not gonna be able to operate your business for X amount of time. That could be 2 weeks, that could be a month, that could be 6 months, that could be a year. During that time, you aren't going to be generating the revenue that you were prior to the loss. So a business interruption is going to do, in short, it's going to indemnify you, it's going to pay for your fixed costs, your loss of profits, and your administrative payroll. So there are, as I mentioned earlier, there are many different ways that you can tailor an insurance policy to fit a startup. I wanted to give you guys just three main points. If you have further questions or would like further detail, feel free to reach out to me. I'd be more than happy to look that over with you.